If you've ever tried playing a game with the Dolphin Emulator, but found said game to have weird graphical glitches, or maybe you just noticed that the performance isn't what it should be, then that could be solved by switching to a custom Mesa Turnip GPU driver instead of relying on the default system driver. And in today's video, I'll be showing you how to change that within Dolphin's settings area. Now, I will assume that you have the Dolphin emulator installed from the Google Play Store already. So the next step is to download an adreno Turnip GPU driver from your most trusted source. I generally get mine from the GitHub repository of Kimchi, which I'll have linked in the video description below. But there are a few developers out there who are compiling their own for the Android community. So it shouldn't matter where this GPU driver is downloaded from. And for those who may not be familiar with which Mesa Turnip GPU driver to download, I'll be sure to link to a dedicated guide that I did, which explains the differences between the various drivers that are out there. You can find that linked in the video description as well. So it won't matter if you've downloaded the latest Qualcomm driver that was extracted from a device which matches the hardware on in your device, or if you actually go with a Mesa Turnip driver instead. Just download the one that you want to test out and then save it to your downloads folder. Now, we can install that GPU driver within the Dolphin emulator by first opening up the application, and then we need to tap on the gear icon in the top right corner to dive into the settings area. From here, we're going to select graphics settings, and then you'll want to scroll all the way down to the bottom and tap on GPU driver. This pop-up menu will tell you which driver the Dolphin emulator is currently using. And since we haven't installed a custom driver yet, we see that it's using version 0.744.12 of the default system driver. And this system driver version will be different depending on which smartphone or tablet you're currently using. But we can change this and install one of those custom GPU drivers by tapping on the Install Driver button right here. That's going to bring up a file explorer where we can browse through the file system and select the newly downloaded GPU driver that we got from the Kimchi GitHub repository, or wherever your driver was downloaded from. After selecting that driver, if everything went smoothly, you'll be told that the GPU driver was installed successfully. And again, we can check to make sure that that went through by tapping on that GPU driver menu to bring up that pop-up menu. So now it will tell us which version of the GPU driver that we currently have installed. With all of that done, your Dolphin emulator is now using a custom GPU driver, and you'll want to try emulating the game again to see if that new GPU driver ended up fixing the issues that you were having. In some cases, these custom Mesa Turnip GPU drivers will only impact the raw performance of the game a small bit. But that could be enough to make it completely playable for you. In most other cases, these custom GPU drivers are there to help fix common graphical glitches that you may be experiencing in the game. Graphical bugs like textures that are not loading properly, sprites that just continue to blink while you're trying to play them, and bugs that may actually cause the emulator to crash entirely. I generally recommend trying multiple Mesa Turnip GPU drivers, since there are usually one or two that will work really well on specific hardware. So it's recommended that you try most, if not all of them, that match the hardware inside your device. And that will help you to see which one works the best for your hardware. However, the updated Qualcomm drivers can also be useful as well. So don't think that you should only try Turnip drivers with this driver feature. I'd love to hear which version you found to perform the best and which device you're using down in the comment section below. And please, do not forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel for more Android content.